In today's programme, we're talking about the author Daniel Keyes, who wrote the story Flowers for Algernon. With me today is Professor Higgins from Manchester University. So, Professor, what can you tell us about Daniel Keyes as a boy?
Daniel Keyes was born in New York in 1927. As a boy, he used to work in a bakery from 4 until 7 in the morning before he went to school. You'll notice that the main character in Flowers for Algernon also works in a bakery.
That's interesting. What did he do when he finished school?
After school, he spent some time in the Navy and then studied psychology at university. Many of his novels are also about psychology. For example, Flowers for Algernon asks the question, how does your intelligence affect your character and how people treat you?
Did he used to write novels at university?
No, he didn't. After university, he taught English at a secondary school. He also taught students who found it very difficult to read. This was another experience he used in Flowers for Algernon. The main character also goes to a school because he cannot read.
So, when did he start writing stories?
While he was a teacher, he also used to write in his spare time. Flowers for Algernon was published as a short story in a magazine in 1959. He later wrote it as a complete novel in 1960.
Was it successful?
It was very successful. It was also made into a film called Charlie in 1968. The story also became a television film and a play.
Did he write any other novels?
Yes, he did. 8 of his books were published, but none of them was as successful as Flowers for Algernon. When he was younger, he also used to write for comics, although he didn't used to use his own name in the comics. He called himself Chris Daniels. He died in 2014, aged 86.
Thank you, Professor.
نسمع مرة تاني بس المرة دي نركز على نطق الكلمات واحنا شايفينها قدامنا.
In today's program, we're talking about the author Daniel Keyes, who wrote the story Flowers for Algernon. With me today is Professor Higgins from Manchester University. So, Professor, what can you tell us about Daniel Keyes as a boy?
Daniel Keyes was born in New York in 1927. As a boy, he used to work in a bakery from 4 until 7 in the morning before he went to school. You'll notice that the main character in Flowers for Algernon also works in a bakery.
That's interesting. What did he do when he finished school?
After school, he spent some time in the Navy and then studied psychology at university. Many of his novels are also about psychology. For example, Flowers for Algernon asks the question, how does your intelligence affect your character and how people treat you?
Did he used to write novels at university?
No, he didn't. After university, he taught English at a secondary school. He also taught students who found it very difficult to read. This was another experience he used in Flowers for Algernon. The main character also goes to a school because he cannot read.
So, when did he start writing stories?
While he was a teacher, he also used to write in his spare time. Flowers for Algernon was published as a short story in a magazine in 1959. He later wrote it as a complete novel in 1960.
Was it successful?
It was very successful. It was also made into a film called Charlie in 1968. The story also became a television film and a play.
Did he write any other novels?
Yes, he did. 8 of his books were published, but none of them was as successful as Flowers for Algernon. When he was younger, he also used to write for comics, although he didn't used to use his own name in the comics. He called himself Chris Daniels. He died in 2014, aged 86.
Thank you, Professor.
واحنا بنسمع للمرة التانية انا علمت على التعبيرات اللي هي في الجرامر بتاعت اليونت بتاعتنا زي ما شوفنا الفيديو اللي فات مع بعض. الجرامر اليونت دي بتكلم عن used to بمعنى اعتاد ان والحاجات اللي بمعاني مختلفة used to برضو. تعالوا نشوف هنا ذكرها ازاي. عندنا في اول مثال بيقول as a boy he used to work in a bakery. اعتاد ان يعمل في bakery مخبز وهو صغير وهو ولد صغير يعني دلوقتي مش شغال كده anymore خلاص. بعد كده بيقول did he used to write novels. كده معناها ده سؤال اللي هي اصلها او اجابتها تبقى he used to write او no he didn't use to write. لما بحب نسأل عن used to بنحولها لدد والفاعل ويوز اللي هو المصدر لان بعد الدد ما يجيش غير المصدر. واجابتها هي تحتها no he didn't use to طبعا بس هو اختصر. عندنا بعد كده جاب he used in flowers for Algernon. الexperience he used هنا used بمعنى يستخدم وليست used بمعنى اعتاد عن. ودي الملحوظة المهمة ان use اصلا الفعل الاساسي معناه يستخدم. الحالة الوحيدة اللي بيجي فيها بمعنى اعتاد ان لما يجي بصيغة used to زي ما شفنا او did he use to كسؤال او verb to be we used to بمعنى معتاد على كده في الوقت الحالي. بعد كده المثال اللي بعدها بيقول he also used to write برضو اعتاد ان يكتب نفس المعنى الاول. وبعد كده جابها لي منفية اهو he didn't use to use. خدت بالكم جاب use ان الاتنين use في نفس الجملة. he didn't use to use لم يعتد ان يستخدم. وهنا بيوضح لك الفرق بين didn't use بمعنى يعتد ان وبين use اللي هو يستخدم. اوكي دي الحاجات اللي هي مذكورة في قطعة الليسننج عن الجرامر. تعال نكمل ونقرا الريدنج مع بعض. الريدنج هو جزء من Flowers for Algernon اللي هو بيتكلم عنها دي الكتاب ده أو ده كل القصة معرفش. المهم القطعة بتقول Charlie Jordan was 32 and worked in a bakery in New York. ده البطل اسمه كده وكان عنده 32 سنة شغال في مخبز. The manager promoted him because he was clever. Promote معناه يحصل على ترقية أو يرقي يعني ده الفعل اللي يرقي واحد في شغله يعني. Charlie had found out how to increase the amount of bread that the bakery produced. دي الحاجة اللي خلت المانجر يرقيه لأن هو عرف طريقة ينتجوا بيها عيش أكتر في المخبز ده. Charlie had worked at the bakery for a long time. When he first started there, the other workers always talked to him. كانوا دايما بيتكلموا معاه. But now they didn't. They didn't يعني في الوقت الحالي بطلوا يتكلموا معاه. Why was this? ليه كان كده؟ بيقول لك a few weeks earlier قبل الموضوع ده بكم اسبوع Charlie had been very different. يعني تشارلي كان مختلف تماما عن الوضع ده. بيقول the workers used to tease him. عندنا used to اهي بتاعتنا وعندنا كلمة tease معناها يضايق الحد او يتريق عليه او يسخر منه بمعنى ده معناها tease. اوكي him because they knew he wasn't clever. ليه كانوا بيضايقوه؟ عشان هما شايفينه كان مش ذكي. He used to sweep the floor and do the jobs that nobody else wanted to do. كان متعود ان هو اللي يكنس الارض ويعمل الوظائف اللي الناس التانية ما بتحبش تعملها. People had always laughed at Charlie because they thought that he was a fool. Fool معناها مغفل او عبيط. فكانوا دايما بيضحكوا عليه. But he didn't use to realize that they were often cruel to him. Didn't use to والمصدر ده اللي احنا التعبير بتاعنا هو لم يعتد أن يدرك، يعني ما كانش فاهم ساعتها أو ما كانش مدرك ساعتها إن هم عادة أو ساعات بيكونوا cruel يعني قاسيين عليه. Now, however, he understood what they said to him. Why had he changed? ده سؤال لينا احنا بقى. بيقول لك زمان ما كانش فاهم، دلوقتي فاهم. طب ايه اللي حصل خلى الموضوع يتغير؟ هيحكي لنا بعدها. بيقول Charlie had always wanted to be clever. دايما كان نفسه يبقى ذكي. A few months before, Charlie had started to go to a special school for adults after work. اعتاد او بدأ سوري يروح مدرسة خاصة للكبار مش الصغيرين بعد الشغل علشان يتعلم فيها أكتر. One day, the teacher at the school told him about Dr. Strauss and Professor Nimmer. بيقول له في دكتور اسمه ستروس وفي أستاذ جامعة اسمه نيمر. بيقول له إيه بقى؟ The teacher said that they could help him learn even more. ممكن يساعدوه إن هو يتعلم أكتر. The next day, Charlie visited Dr. Strauss and Professor Nimmer. راح زارهم ما كدبش خبر. They said they wanted to use him in an experiment. هنا use بمعنى يستخدم. يستعملوه في تجربة to become clever. They took Charlie to a laboratory where scientists asked him to find the way through a maze. طلبوا منه ان هو يجد طريقه عبر متاهة. ميز يعني متاهة، ومعنى الجملة دي ان هو دخلوه متاهة قالوا له يلا يا شاطر اطلع منها. It was too difficult for Charlie. The scientist then showed him a mouse called Algernon. They put Algernon in the maze and the mouse ran through it in just a few seconds. يعني في الأول لما حطوا تشارلي قالوا له اطلع من المتاهة كانت صعب جدا عليه ومعرفش. بعدها حطوا فار اسمه ألجرنن، راحوا حطوه في المتاهة وقالوا له بص على الفار ده، لقى الفار بيجري بسرعة وفي ثواني صغيرة قليلة جدا قدر يحل المتاهة دي ويقدر يطلع منها. دكتور ستروس said that Algernon used to be a normal mouse. Then they did an operation on it and it became very clever. بعد كده دكتور ستروس ده قال للراجل ان الفار ده كان فار عادي زمان، كان normal. بعد كده احنا عملنا له عملية، اجرينا عليه عملية وأصبح very clever. بيقول له يعني أنت هيبقى مستقبلك كده شاطر زي. مهم they wanted to do the same operation on Charlie وهي agreed. هم كانوا عايزين يعملوا نفس العملية على تشارلي اللي هو البني آدم وهو وافق. After the operation, Charlie slowly became more and more intelligent. بعد ما العملية خلصت بدأ يصبح ذكي أكتر. Dr. Strauss and Professor Nimmer were delighted. Delighted يعني مبسوطين. With this progress, بالتقدم ده. They took him to a meeting with other scientists in a different city. خدوه لاجتماعات في بلاد مختلفة مع علماء تانيين. But Charlie now understood more about science than they did. يعني هو أذكى منهم بعد العملية. He was angry with the men. Angry with معناها كان متعصب بسببهم أو متعصب منهم يعني. He realized that they were treating him like a laboratory animal. هو أدرك إن هم بيعاملوه زي حيوان التجارب بتاع المعمل. So he took Algernon from its cage and returned to New York. راح واخد الفار الذكي بتاعهم وخد بعضه ومشي رجع نيويورك تاني. At home, Charlie started to study Algernon carefully. بدأ هو في البيت يدرس الفار ده بعناية، يدرسه بقى يدرس تصرفاته يعني. He realized that the mouse wasn't clever anymore. الماوس بطل يبقى ذكي خلاص. It had become a normal mouse again. رجع فار طبيعي مرة تاني. بعد كده بيسأل سؤال تعجبي بيقول Would the same thing happen to him? هل هيحصل نفس الحاجة لتشارلي ان هو هيرجع طبيعي تاني؟ وهنا تخلص قطعة الريدنج. نشوف مع بعض شوية تعريفات للكلمات اللي جت فيها. بيقول لنا في نيفي، نيفي دي كانت في الليسننج، النيفي ده اللي هو الأسطول يا جماعة، النيفي اللي هو الأسطول. بيقول لي the people and the ships that used to protect a country، السفن والناس اللي بيستخدموا في إن هم يحموا البلد. spare time، spare time ده وقت الفراغ، اللي هو time when you aren't working or studying، أو بتعملش حاجة مفيدة. psychology، psychology ده علم الدماغ أو علم دراسة المخ، مش المخ الجسدي يعني جسديا، لأ يعني الحاجات المتعلقة بالمخ. psychology زي النفسيات كده يعني. بيقول لك the scientific study of mind، المايند الفكر يعني دراسة العقل ودراسة الفكر. maze، maze اللي هي المتاهة. designed road which are difficult to find your way in، يعني طريق معد انك ممكن تتوه فيه وما تعرفش تلاقي طريقك. promote، promote اللي هو يرقي الحد، to give someone a better job in a company او in اي وظيفة. normal اللي هو usual الطبيعي. cage اللي هو القفص. something is made of wires to keep birds and or animals in. okay، حاجة معمولة wires اللي هي الأسلاك عشان يجيب ال birds وال animals in، يعني يخليهم موجودين جوه القفص ما يهربوش. comic، الكوميك ده اللي هو كتب المصورة، اللي هو زي المجلات كده، عن زي ميكي كده، ده كوميك. telling a story with picture، بتحكي قصة بالصور. fool اللي هو العبيط، a stupid person. cruel، cruel يعني قاسي. unkind غير عطوف. hurting people deliberately، خدنا deliberately قبل كده بمعنى عمدا أو عن عمد، بتأذي الناس وانت متعمد، انت قاسي. tease to laugh at a person and make him embarrassed، تحرجه، بتحرجه وبتضحك عليه زي ما قلناها في أول الفيديو كده. الـ listening والـ reading بتاعت unit 5 خلصوا. بفكركم بجروب الواتساب والفيسبوك، لينكاتهم في الديسكريبشن تحت لو حد احتاج حاجة أو يسأل في حاجة. وأشوفكم على خير إن شاء الله في unit 6.